So, as already discussed, why do we fall ill? This chapter that deals with the diseases, the particular type of the diseases, the health conditions, as well as the conditions of the disease, being diseased, being disease free, or being healthy. That is what we have to study in this chapter. What are the various types of the diseases? What are the various methods by which the, or the modes by which the diseases are spread? What are the various categories of the organisms that lead to the spread of the diseases, or the organisms that actually help to, that are basically responsible for creating the diseases in the human beings as well as the other living organisms. So this is all in this chapter, and how to get rid of it, right? How to be treated, how to be prevented, and how to be immunized. These are the topics that we have already covered from this chapter. And this chapter was there in your exams. So you people have already learned it. Okay. So now we are to only revise these particular topics, and based upon those, you'll be also asked certain questions, right? So starting with the first, that is the conditions of being healthy, the conditions of being diseased and disease free. So already discussed that what are these conditions? Sabse pehle, health. What is health? When we talk about the health, we say that a person who is physically, mentally, as well as socially interactive or fit, who is physically, socially, and mentally fit. This can be also looked over by another perspective, that is emotionally fit. Okay, being emotionally fit means that is you are emotionally balanced. Okay, so this is physical, social, and mental fitness that counts for the health conditions. Okay, so being socially, mentally, as well as physically fit, we call it as healthy. Disease is when we are having certain discomfort in our body. Disease ka matlab kya hai? Dis ease. Dis ka matlab kya hota hai? That is without. Ease ka matlab kya hai? That is comfort. So discomfort, jab hame koi disease hai, jab hum discomforted hain, when we are without comfort, means we are not having that particular comfortable zone. And I am feeling like I am having anything like I am suffering with a fever. Okay. If I am suffering with fever, will I be physically fit? No. Will I be socially interactive? No. Will I be mentally stable? No. Right. So means I am not healthy, but I am diseased. Diseased is when there is a pathogen in your body. Not only pathogen, but also we say we are diseased when there is some other lacking of the nutrients in your body. If your body is not getting the proper nutrients, that is malnutrition is there, then there is certain problems which are related to the body, that which we can call them as diseases again, right? For example, let's say, hum logon ne ek choti classes mein bhi aap logon ne padha hoga, that is marasmus and kawashiokar, two types of the diseases which are related with the protein malnutrition. And so protein malnutrition means that is a deficiency of proteins. Certain components in our body, they are required to an appropriate amount. If we don't get them, the diseases will occur. That is, we will be suffering with the big type of the symptoms, and there will be big problems related to our body. And hence we call that as disease. We categorize it as disease. Or simply when a pathogen enters into our body, the pathogen can be a bacteria, a virus, a fungal member, or anything, protozoans, you know, aap logon ko padhaye hain aage bhi pehle. To jab bhi koi pathogen enter kar jaye, ya agar hamari body mein koi malnutrition ho jaye, yani ki hamari body mein koi deficiency of the nutrients ho jaye, then we call that state as not being healthy but being diseased, right? We are having a discomfort, but the reason was no pathogen and no malnutrition, right? Matlab, hum log ko discomfort feel ho raha hai. This is simple. If I am having a stomach ache, right? If I am having a stomach ache, I am neither physically fit nor socially fit. Interactive bhi nahi na hota banda. Aaj mera agar pet dard ho raha hai, to main socially interactive nahi hungi. Main baat nahi karungi kisi se, hai na? Aap bhi aisa karte. So this is socially hum log fit nahi rehte, hai na? So if we are not physically or socially or mentally fit, we are not stable enough, then we see we are not healthy. But again, we are not suffering because of any reason. Pet upset hai, okay, kuch kam zyada kha liya, isliye upset hai, yahan pe aapka pet dard ho raha hai. ठीक है. सो उसकी वजह से अगर कोई प्रॉब्लम हो गया जस्ट फॉर अ बिट टाइम, देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ कंडीशन विच इज डिजीज फ्री. इट इज हैविंग अ स्टेट ऑफ अनहेल्दीनेस, दैट इज हैविंग अ स्टेट ऑफ द विदाउट कंफर्टनेस, बट इट इज नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ एनी पैथोजन or the deficiency of any nutrient, then we call it as a state which is called as disease free. We can say it is an intermediate stage. ठीक है, इन दोनों के बीच की स्टेज है, that is disease free. Getting right? So healthy, disease and disease free, these are the three conditions that one should know before reading this particular chapter. Now we are to deal with the diseases and its types. Okay, so diseases, the various types of the diseases. What are diseases? हमने अभी पढ़ा. Diseases without comfort. When there is a pathogen in the body, especially when there is a pathogen, otherwise other things can also be there. So when there is a pathogen within a body, pathogen क्या होता है? Disease causing agent. Okay, so when there is a pathogen within our body, then the particular person suffers from the disease, right? Now the types of the diseases which can be categorized accordingly. We have discussed the three categories, but in your books there are only two categories. So depending upon the type of diseases, depending upon the transmission, that is separate. Okay, means it can be separate from a infected person to a normal healthy person, it can be separated or it can't. So depending upon the transmission of or the spread, we can categorize the diseases as the two categories, that is infectious diseases and non-infectious diseases. Infectious are also called as communicable means that which can spread from the infected person to a normal healthy person. Okay, and non-infectious means non-communicable, which can't be communicated in a population, means which can't be spread in a population. So these are called as non-communicable diseases. This is the first method by which we can classify the diseases or we can study the various types of diseases. This is the first category. The second category, that is again in your books, and that is depending upon the duration. For how long does the disease stay within the body? Depending upon duration of the disease for staying within the body. Now the duration. For duration, we can classify this into the two categories that are called as acute diseases and chronic diseases. The acute and the chronic diseases, they are not given any other names, but this can be simply called as, acutes can be called as a short spanned diseases and chronic can be called as a long spanned diseases. Okay, long term diseases or short term diseases, right? Okay, now the next is the third, which is not in your books, but we have discussed in the class, and this is depending upon the origin of the disease, depending upon that how, not how, but when has it originated. Okay, so depending upon the time of origin of lexapto ya fir when it has originated. Okay, so depending upon the origin of the disease, that is related to the time. Time means when, at what part of your life, that is by birth or during the life. Okay, so this can be further categorized into the one which is by birth. Ek hai diseases hamare paas jo by birth milti hain new organisms ko, and these diseases which are by birth, that is a new being gets it by birth at the time of the birth, these diseases are called as congenital diseases. congenital diseases by birth. That is congenital. Congenital diseases. And the ones which we achieve, that is which we acquire, not achieve, acquire during the lifespan. Okay? So yahan pe likho, that which are acquired during the life span. That is during the life. If you acquire any of the diseases, then those diseases are called as acquired diseases. Right? And we ask you one second. Now further. Okay. Coming to the next, that is now we are to discuss about these differences, about the different diseases. Okay. So differences kya hain? That is, what are the differences between the infectious and the non-infectious, first of all? So what are the differences between the infectious and the non-infectious? As already told, that infectious diseases are those which can spread from one person to the another. Okay. So these infectious or the communicable diseases, they are the one that can spread from a infected person, an infected person to healthy person. Healthy person means the one who was not carrying any disease. Okay, initially he was healthy, but after the spread, उसके बाद क्या है? उनको भी disease हो गया. तो ये infection जो है, वो आगे जा सकता है. So that is why it is called as infectious or called as communicable. ठीक है? So it can be communicated. Communication क्या होता है? That is when we communicate via the phone. We say with one person to then another person, and we are calling and we are just communicating. So are the diseases communicable. क्यों कहा जाता है इनको communicable? ये भी question हो सकता है आपके लिए. Why the infectious are called as communicable? The infectious are called as communicable because they can be in a population, they can be spread from one person to the another. Same answers hain. And why the communicables can be called as infectious? ठीक है, that can also be a question. क्योंकि the infection spreads from the one person to the another, or from the infected person to the healthy person. Okay, so that is the interchangeable names, right? So this is the first feature, that is the infectious diseases. Whereas these diseases, the non-infectious ones, these diseases can't spread from one person to the another. So the spread can't be there. Okay, so they can't spread from one person to the another, or from the infected person to the healthy person. The non-communicable or the non-infectious diseases, they can't spread, right? Okay. Now coming to the second. Infectious, if it has to communicate, means as I just simply talked about the communication, a simple communication, that of the via the means of communication, that is by the phone, hai na? So we need a medium. हमें एक फोन चाहिए था, या हमें ईमेल चाहिए, या पोस्ट कार्ड चाहिए, कुछ भी मीड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन चाहिए, मोड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन चाहिए, है ना? देन ओनली वी कैन कम्युनिकेट विद द अदर पर्सन, है ना? वी सिटिंग फार ऑफ. तो यहाँ पे कम्युनिकेबल के लिए भी कुछ ना कुछ मीन या मोड चाहिए बीच में, है ना? दिस रिक्वायर्स अ पर्टिकुलर मीडियम बाय विच दिस कैन बी कम्युनिकेटेड फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन टू द नॉर्मल हेल्दी पर्सन, है ना? तो फॉर दैट दीज इन्फेक्शियस और द कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेस, दे रिक्वायर सर्टन एजेंट्स. Right, since it has not to be spread, so no agents, है ना? तो ये हम इसका second point of difference बना सकते हैं. This requires agents for the spread, है ना? So they require agents for spread of these kind of the diseases. Whereas the non-infectious will not require any type of the एजेंट, बिकॉज दे आर नॉट टू सपरेट, उन्होंने सपरेट ही नहीं करना. ठीक है, तो एजेंट की कोई जरूरत ही नहीं है, एजेंट की बात ही नहीं है बीच में. ठीक है, सो दैट इज नॉन कम्युनिकेबल आर दोस विच रिक्वायर, विच डू नॉट रिक्वायर एनी एजेंट्स, वेयर एज द इन्फेक्शियस और द कम्युनिकेबल्स, दे रिक्वायर द एजेंट्स फॉर देयर सपरेट, फॉर द सपरेट ऑफ दोस डिजीजेस. राइट, ओके. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट. अब यहाँ पे अगर आप ये पॉइंट बनाते हैं that the infectious diseases can be less harmful or more harmful non-infectious ka comparatively, so that is wrong. Theek hai, there are several diseases which being infectious are more harmful, non-infectious are also harmful, नॉन इन्फेक्शियस कैन सिंपल बी मतलब दे कैन ऑल्सो बी लाइक द सिंपल डिजीजेस, इन्फेक्शियस कैन ऑल्सो बी लाइक द सिंपल डिजीजेस जैसे कॉमन कोल्ड है ना. तो ऐसा कोई पॉइंट नहीं बनाएंगे जो एक कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल स्टेटमेंट देता है. ठीक है, वी विल नॉट बी मेकिंग एनी सच पॉइंट विच इज गोइंग टू गिव यू अ कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल पॉइंट ऑफ डिफरेंस. ठीक है, पॉइंट ऑफ डिफरेंस मीन्स अ क्लियर कट पॉइंट ऑफ डिफरेंस. अब यहाँ पे अगर हम ये बोलें दोनों को, दिस डज नॉट रिक्वायर, इसमें भी लिख लो, दिस डज नॉट रिक्वायर एजेंट. अब यहाँ पे अगर मैं आपसे पूछूंगी दैट इज देयर एनी कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी बिटवीन दीज टू पॉइंट, इज देयर एनी कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी? नो, देयर इज नो कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी बिटवीन दीज टू पॉइंट्स, है कि नहीं? ये दोनों पॉइंट्स एक साथ में पूरे के पूरे क्लियर है एंड कम्प्लीटली सेज यस दिस इज दिस एंड दिस इज दिस, है ना. तो हमने जब भी पेपर में भी बेटा जब भी आपने डिफरेंस पॉइंट्स बनाने होते हैं, व्हाट यू डू इज यू पीपल मेक द डिफरेंसेस ऑन द स्पॉट ऑफ योर एग्जाम, है ना. यू नेवर प्रिपेयर द डिफरेंसेस बिफोर हैंड. अब ये तो हमारे पास जनरल कैटेगरीज हैं इसीलिए हम लोग इसके डिफरेंसेज जो है आपके सामने बना रहे हैं, आपको पता चल रहे हैं. लेकिन जब आपके पास पेपर आएगा तो पेपर में हो सकता है कोई अलग तरह का डिफरेंस दे रहे हैं, है ना, कुछ अलग तरह की कोई टर्म्स दे रही मैंने आपको, डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द इन्फेक्शियस एंड द क्यूट, कुछ भी, दिस इज नॉट अ एक्चुअल क्वेश्चन. बट अगर ऐसे मैंने कुछ भी कंपैरिजन कुछ और बना दिया, देन व्हाट यू आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट इज यू विल बी थिंकिंग एंड राइटिंग द आंसर देयर इटसेल्फ. यू वोंट बी क्रिएटिंग द डिफरेंसेस इन माइंड मेंटली फॉर द सिमिलर टर्म्स और द सिमिलर थिंग्स बिफोर हैंड, जिसकी वजह से आप तब जब बैठ के बनाते हो तो कुछ भी लिखते हो आपको लगता है वो डिफरेंस पॉइंट है और वो सही है, वो गलत हो सकते हैं. ठीक है, सो व्हाट आई सजेस्ट इज ऑलवेज क्रिएट द डिफरेंसेस इन योर माइंड, बी मेंटली प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर दोज पॉइंट्स विच आर नॉट हैविंग एनी पर्टिकुलर कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी एज द डिफरेंसेस. ओके, ठीक है, सो दीज आर द टू पॉइंट्स. थर्ड पॉइंट यू कैन मेकअप फॉर द अदर नेम्स एंड द फोर्थ इज दैट ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स. Now, can anyone of you please give me the examples for infectious and non-infectious diseases? Raise your hands. Yes. Anji Shivansh. Just say for infectious. Shivansh, unmute karo beta.
Ma'am, COVID-19, SARS, measles.
COVID-19 is the best example that which is running nowadays and that is infectious. Simple saying common cold, abhi maine bola bhi tha aapko, hai na? So that is an example, that is common cold. And also one thing, if you are writing the other examples which are not explained or which are not given any concern in your NCERTs, then you should be very much sure with that this is a particular disease which is going to be spread because of this particular agent, ya jo bhi, hai na? Because what happened in your exams, your answer sheets when they were checked for the last exams, PT3, तो बहुत सारे बच्चों ने अपने से bacterial diseases दो पूछी थी, दो protozoan पूछी थी, दो viral पूछी थी, कुछ इस तरह से. तो जो जो diseases आप लोगों ने लिखी, you were not even sure with कि ये कौन सा disease है, whether it is a viral or it's a bacterial, and you were just writing, है ना. That should not be there to secure good marks, that is to secure your marks. Basically आप लोगों को जैसे मैंने पहले भी बताया starting of the chapter में कि यही एक चैप्टर है आपके सिलेबस में, है ना. तो यू आर टू जस्ट फिक्स अप योर फुल मार्क्स. ये बायो वाले पूरे नंबर तो आपने लेने ही लेने हैं, उसके लिए यू शुड बी फिक्स्ड विद योर आंसर्स. ठीक है, दैट मींस आप लोग को पहले पता होना चाहिए कि डिजीज है तो ये बैक्टीरियल डिजीज है, ये वायरल है, ये इन्फेक्शियस है या नॉन इन्फेक्शियस है, ये एक्यूट है या क्रॉनिक है. ठीक है, तो ये चीजें तुम्हें पहले से पता होनी चाहिए, फिक्स्ड होनी चाहिए तुम्हारे माइंड में, एंड यू विल figure it out. If not possibly आपको बुक में से आंसर नहीं मिल रहा, you can figure it out from internet, है ना. बट आपके पास fixed answers होने चाहिए, confusion basis कुछ नहीं होना चाहिए. और ऐसे में अगर आप अपने नंबर गवाते हैं, that will not be a good thing, है ना, that will not be a good approach. हाँ जी अपरन, tell me about non-communicable diseases.
मैम diabetes, hypertension, goiter.
Diabetes, hypertension and goiter, I can write. Hypertension is because of something like your body is not working appropriately and because of certain tensions and every stress kind of the conditions. So hypertension can't be considered here. In non-infectious, like your diseases, नहीं हो सकती अच्छी वाली मतलब जो diseases, type diseases होती है. और diabetes भी जो होता है ना, that is actually congenital. ठीक है, वो infectious नॉन इन्फेक्शियस हम लेते हैं लेकिन वो फ्रॉम पेरेंट्स को एक्सप्लेन आ जाती है, ठीक है, तो इसमें डायबिटीज भी नहीं लेना इसमें. हाँ जी रमनी.
कैंसर, डायबिटीज.
डायबिटीज की तो बात बोल रही हूँ मैं, सुनो सुनो रमनी जी, म्यूट योरसेल्फ. हाँ जी सुनो, डायबिटीज का ही मैं कंसेप्ट आपको बोल रही थी बेटा. डायबिटीज है, नॉन इन्फेक्शियस है, लेकिन वो हेरिडिटरी भी है, ठीक है, पेरेंट्स से ऑफस्प्रिंग्स में हो जाती है, कंजेनिटल है. तो अगर एक से दूसरे पर्सन हो जाती है तो हम उसको नॉन इन्फेक्शियस नहीं लेते हैं ना, वो इन्फेक्शियस में ही काउंट होगी. पर हम उसको अप्रोप्रिएटली इन्फेक्शियस भी नहीं लिख सकते क्योंकि वो किसी भी बंदे से किसी भी और दूसरे पर्सन में नहीं हो सकती, है ना. तो ऐसी फिर से वही बातें आ रही ना, मैं आपको क्या बोली हूँ कि आपने कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल स्टेटमेंट नहीं लिखना, कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल कोई भी एग्जाम्पल नहीं लिखना. तो डायबिटीज इफ वी आर हैविंग दिस कंसेप्ट इन द माइंड की वो पेरेंट्स से ऑफस्प्रिंग में चले जाती है, दैट इज बाय बर्थ हो सकती है डायबिटीज की जो प्रॉब्लम्स होती है ना. तो वो बाय बर्थ अगर कोड हो जाती है तो उसको नॉन इन्फेक्शियस में कैसे दे रहे हो आप? इट इज गेटिंग फ्रॉम वन पर्सन टू अनदर, मेड बी ओनली अ पेरेंट फ्रॉम द पेरेंट टू द ऑफस्प्रिंग, पर है तो है ना, तो नहीं लिखो, ठीक है. कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल आंसर्स एग्जाम्पल्स नहीं लिखो जिससे हो सके कि आपके नंबर कट जाए, ठीक है, वो चीज नहीं लिखो, राइट. So, Walter, I have mentioned cancer, you said. I'll be writing cancer here. ठीक है, कैंसर जो है वो फिर से हमारी बॉडी में, इट इज नॉट लाइक हाइपरटेंशन जैसा कंडीशन नहीं है, पर अगर ये कैंसर होता है किसी को तो दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ सम केमिकल्स, बिकॉज ऑफ सर्टन ऑफ द यू कैन से एजेंट्स दैट विच कैन कॉज द कैंसर. कार्सिनोजेंस होते हैं कुछ एजेंट्स जिसकी वजह से कैंसरस कंडीशंस जो है वो बन जाती हैं, एंड हेंस द अनकंट्रोल्ड division of the cells which is called as cancer may lead, right. तो वो uncontrolled division होनी शुरू हो जाती है cells की उन chemicals की वजह से, और जिसको हम लोग बोलते हैं cancer, ठीक है. तो that is a disease called as cancer and hence it can't be spread from one person to another. वो जिसके अंदर उन chemicals की कोई मतलब disorder हुआ है, कोई problems हुई है, वो उसी के अंदर ही रहेंगी, it will not be spread to the other person of the family, okay. So this is the infectious and the non-infectious diseases, right. Next categories will be doing it, revising it further. So for today, because your time is also over, so for today you will be revising the first topic, the introduction, the first topic of health disease and disease free, and the second, that is infectious and non-infectious, okay. Tomorrow I'll start with the questioning of these topics and further the revision of the other parts. Done. Anything you want to ask? Yes, anybody wants to ask anything? Yes, Ashna.